You are not going to believe how many there are. 8. Yes, you heard me correctly. 8. Phonak now have 8 hearing aids within their Lumity family, 5 of which have literally just been released in August 2023. So today I'll expand on exactly what they are, if they're suitable for you, and then most importantly, what I like and even what I dislike about them. And then finally, I'll share some insider information on what I also think is missing from them. Not want to do things by halves, on August the 9th in the US and August the 21st in the UK, Phonak added these 5 new models of hearing aids to the Phonak Lumity family. The Audeo Lumities were released in August 2022, which included the Lumity R, Lumity RT, and Lumity Life. You'll notice that these are all receiver and canal hearing aids, and they're so good that they made it into my top hearing aids of 2023, which I'll link in the description to today's video. I also have a full breakdown of the tech in this video too, so they're definitely worth checking out at some point. Up until this announcement, all of the other models of Phonak hearing aids were running previous versions of Phonak technology, whether that was the Sky hearing aid running the Marvel platform or the Naída, Virto and CROS on the Paradise platform. So you're probably sat there wondering what these different names mean. Phonak have always consistently used the same names for their different form factors of hearing aids, with the Audeo being their receiver and canal model, the Naída their power behind the ear hearing aid, the Sky being Phonak's behind the ear pediatric hearing aids, the CROS system is used to manage single-sided deafness, and then finally the Virto is their custom-made in-the-ear hearing aid. So today's announcement, cue drumroll, is 2 new Naídas, 2 new Skies, and also a brand new CROS hearing aid, all of which are on Phonak's new Lumity platform. For those of you out there unfamiliar with the Lumity platform, it runs all of the same features as the Phonak Paradise, however with 2 key developments, which Phonak call their SmartSpeech technology. This all runs under their new automatic program, AutoSense 5.0. This scans your environment 700 times per second and automatically adapts to your unique listening situation. The first of these developments is Phonak's first ever update to their Stereozoom to version 2.0. And secondly, they've introduced a brand new feature called Speech Sensor. Kicking off now with Stereozoom, this is Phonak's directional microphone technology, which is a feature that Phonak have had in their hearing aids for almost 10 years now, since their Quest platform. And we haven't seen any changes to this feature since its initial release, so it's well and truly in need of a revamp. Stereozoom is designed to quite aggressively focus the microphones of your hearing aids in a forwardly direction when you're in a noisy environment, such as a restaurant, with the hope that you want to hear whatever you're looking at. With this upgrade to Lumity, Phonak are boasting that Stereozoom 2.0 is their smoother, smarter, and stronger binaural beamformer. So in practice, this means that rather than the directional beamformer either being on or off, as it is with the Paradise range, it will adapt to the noise around you and therefore have a slower, more gradual and smoother activation. It will do so in such a way that it will give the optimum strength of Stereozoom based on your specific sound environment. Now, I know this all sounds pretty complicated and you're probably thinking, well, Matthew, what does this mean for me? Well, when activated, it should give you a greater awareness of your environmental sounds as well as the person in front of you when surrounding noise levels are a little bit lower. And then if the noise levels pick up, then there's a gradual focus on the person in front of you. If you've ever felt this feature kick in with previous generations of hearing aids, it can make you feel a bit like you're trapped in a bubble when you're in a noisy environment, which Phonak are boasting should now no longer happen. For those of you out there into your numbers, Phonak state that this should give you a better signal-to-noise ratio by up to 2.5 decibels. And this should result in a 16% better speech understanding compared to fixed directionality settings and also previous versions of Stereozoom. The second brand new feature is called Speech Sensor. This is a 360-degree speech detection algorithm designed to improve your hearing of conversations from the right, the left, or even behind you. Now, Phonak state from their research that 80% of conversations generally come from in front of us, with the other 20% from either behind or the side. And one downside of older directional microphone technology is that it can focus so aggressively towards the front of you that it actually cuts out that other 20%. This new feature is designed to identify conversations happening close by from all other directions, and then open up the beamformer in a noisy environment to a more omnidirectional setting, allowing you to pick up that speech without you necessarily needing to look at the person speaking. Again, for the number folks, this should result in a 3.4 decibel better signal-to-noise ratio and also 15% better speech understanding when you have somebody speaking to you from the side. Now, something that I really want to put across is that this technology will not resolve all of your hearing issues in background noise, and it's still incredibly important to maximize the amount of information that you use to communicate, i.e. focus on lip reading and contextual information. There is, however, no question that there are improvements over and above the Paradise family of hearing aids. The two new Naída Lumity hearing aids start with the Naída LPR, which is Phonak's rechargeable power hearing aid, and then we have the Naída LUP, which uses a 675 disposable battery and is the slightly larger and more powerful of the two. Both hearing aids sport built-in Bluetooth to allow you to directly connect your hearing aids to your phone. However, rather frustratingly, only the LUP has a telecoil and only the LPR is cross-compatible, which I'll come on to what that means shortly. So make sure that you do your research on which is the most appropriate for you before you order these hearing aids. Similarly to the Naída Lumity, the Sky Lumity comes in two different models. The Sky LPR, which is Phonak's rechargeable power hearing aid, and the Sky LUP, which uses a 675 disposable battery again, and is also the slightly larger and more powerful of the two. Again, both hearing aids sport built-in Bluetooth to allow you to connect your hearing aids directly to your phone, with only the LUP having a telecoil, and again, only the LPR being cross-compatible. Both of these hearing aids are available in the wildest range of colors that I've seen from any hearing aid manufacturer, with 14 different color options to choose from. So I'm sure you're all wondering what all this talk is about the new CROS Lumity, and I've got a video covering exactly this in huge amounts of detail coming up soon. But in summary, if you're somebody with an unaidable hearing loss in one ear, i.e. no hearing at all, and either normal hearing or a hearing loss that requires a hearing aid in the other, then you can wear some really smart technology called a CROS system. A CROS system is essentially a transmitter that detects any sound that arrives to the poor hearing ear. It then wirelessly transmits the sound to your better hearing ear, giving you access to the world of sound around you in 360 degrees. And I've had a ton of experience using them, and they can have a huge impact on people's lives. So the million-dollar question is, what's missing? The Phonak Virto Paradise, which is Phonak's custom-made range of hearing aids, were released in 2022, and they're the last model of Phonak hearing aids still running on their old Paradise platform. This is pretty normal for Phonak, and based on their historical releases of hearing aids, their in-the-ear products do tend to lag behind their behind-the-ear counterparts. I think this is mainly due to them not being as popular as behind-the-ear hearing aids, so in fairness, that's where all of their focus initially tends to be with the release of new hearing aid technology. In my opinion, we're unlikely to see an in-the-ear Lumity hearing aid for at least another 18 months to 2 years. So if you're waiting for its release, I think you'd be better to trial the Virto Paradise rather than waiting. That just about summarizes Phonak's latest Lumity release. I'd love to know what you guys watching think about this new family of hearing aids. Drop me a note in the comments beneath this video. Press like if you found this video useful, and to be notified of my full detailed feature reviews on these new hearing aids, then make sure that you subscribe by pressing this circle just here. I'll see you in the next video.